As promised in last Sunday's tutorial, this video is about copying and moving events and libraries. They do slightly different things and you should be aware of it. I'll show you how to do it. Also, I'll show you how to have the same clip in several libraries that refers to the same original footage. This in turn will save space on your hard disk. And finally, I'll explain about trashing a file. Sometimes it's even retained in the library, even though you've asked it to go in the trash. I'm Bruce Macbryde, and my goal is to improve your knowledge and to speed up your workflow in Final Cut. In the description below, there are timestamps that will help you move between the different parts of this video. And YouTube is a good place to learn Final Cut. But sometimes these tutorials that are pre-recorded don't answer your questions as they come to your mind. I can help you with personal tuition over the internet via Skype. If you've not already done so, please like, subscribe, and press the bell. So you can copy from an event to a library, or you can drag from an event to a library. It's the same thing. So if we select something in our browser, let's select the Final Cut logo. And if we want to copy that now to another library, we can simply come to the File menu and select Copy to Library. And I'm going to send it to the August Test Library. And then it asks us, do we want to include the original media, the optimized or the proxy? Obviously, you make the decisions there. And then when we look up here, we can see that it's created a new event in the August Test Library. If I just undo that for the moment, and we come back to the original library and select it here and drag that, now we can do the same thing, but this time we can actually put it in an event that already exists so that we don't have to create a new event. And of course it asks us for the same information, whether we want to include the original media, etc. And then there it is. So the same thing has happened. And if we want to move an item from one library to another, we can select it in the event in the first library, August Tutorials. Then we can come to the File menu and select Move to Library and move that to the Test Library. Do we want optimized media or proxy? And because we're moving it, Final Cut has assumed that we want the original media anyway, so we don't have to select that. Say OK to this, and you'll see that a new event has been created in the August test, and that then can be then moved into the event that we want. If we go back to the original, and we can see that that iMovie logo is no longer in the August Tutorials library or in the event within that library. And the same thing happens when you move a project from one event to another. So if I'm in this project here and I select the stabilization and drag it through to another project and release it, then you can see that it's appeared in that project. And if we go back to the original project it was in, it's been removed from that project. And there is a way to have the clip in both events. So back to this event here, and if we select the clip, and now if we start dragging, but as we're dragging, hold the Option key down and drag it into the other event, you can see it's in that event there, and it's still in this event here. So we produced two copies, but the interesting thing with this is that they in fact both refer to the same original media on your hard disk. So you haven't actually increased the storage on your disk. If we check on this clip now and reveal in Finder, and it's in the Apps for FCP event where it originated from. If we now go to the item that we copied and reveal that in Finder, then you can see that that is also in that same original position. So it's the same original in both of these events. If you drag a clip from one library to a project in another library, the original footage is copied to that library that has that project. If it's a compound clip, then all of the items that are in that clip are also copied to that library. If we see here, this item here is a compound clip, if I drag that now and drag it into this library here, where the plunge pool is, then it's going to ask me, what do I want to include? And if I look in there, then these are the components of that compound clip. So finally, let's see what actually happens when you ask a clip to move to the trash. It doesn't do what you'd expect. So if we go to this plunge pool and we see that this clip is in this project down here, if I right click on the clip in the browser, I can ask it to go to the trash. And yes, it's been removed from the browser, but it's still in the timeline. Because it's still in the timeline, Final Cut still keeps it in the original media. So let's have a look. We'll go to Reveal in Finder and we'll open the package and we'll have a look in the original media. And there is the file currently in the timeline, even though you asked it to go to the trash. Now, if I want to move that clip from the timeline, when I right click on it, it doesn't give me any choice to remove it. But if I select it now and press the delete key, and then it will come up with this warning, one or more media files will be moved to the trash since the last reference to them is being deleted. But the external files will still stay in place. And as you should be aware, Final Cut never affects the original files on the disk, no matter what you do with them. And of course, it's actually moved to the trash, and you can bring it back if you want to, because it's retained there until you empty the trash. Of course, it's gone from the original media file on your hard disk. And to check that, let's go to Finder, right click, show package contents, and you can see that it's no longer there. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new tutorials every Sunday.